That which is required in your salat, that makes your salat valid, is the Fatiha. You do not have to recite anything other than the Fatiha if you don't want to. After the Fatiha, the Prophet ﷺ said, recite that which is easy for you. So if Qul huwa Allahu ahad is easy, say it. Qul a'udhu birabbi nas, say it. Whatever is easy for you. But that which is required is the Fatiha. The standing position is called what? Everybody. Everybody, the standing position is called what? Okay, alhamdulillah. So Qiyam, we recite the opening supplication, we recite the Fatiha, and whatever is easy for us. Now we're going into the next position. The next position, as you see, I have it written down. This is called, everybody say after me, Ruku.
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 Ruku. Okay, this means bowing. So the next position, which is the bowing position, this is called Ruku. Okay, Ruku. When we go into the Ruku position, now pay attention. When we go into the Ruku position, the same way we went into the Takbir Tahreem. Now we're going into the Ruku position, which is the bowing position. I make Takbir, meaning again, I raise my hand. So now I'm here, I finished the Fatiha. I finished something small. Now I'm going to go into the next position, which is Ruku. I say, Allahu Akbar. And I say, Allahu Akbar. I raise my hands to my shoulders or to my ears again. And now I go into the Ruku position, which is the bowing position. In the bowing position, very carefully, how do I bow now? First thing is, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said that he would level his back so that it would be parallel to the ground, so that if he were to put a cup on top of his back, it wouldn't spill. So his back has to be straight, parallel to the ground, not over, not like this, but it must be parallel to the ground. Parallel, okay? Also, your hands, pay attention. Your hands go over your knees. They are spread out. The palms of your hands go on top of your knees. And your hands are spread out like this. Okay? Your hands are on top of your knees. Your fingers are spread out. And your elbows are out. Okay? To the point that you can see the underarms. Okay? So therefore, we say Allahu Akbar, boom. The hands are on the knees. Okay? The hands are on the knees. The fingers are out. My back is straight. Okay? My eyes are still pointed toward the ground. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, your salat is not valid if you do not hold every position. So when you go into this Allahu Akbar, bam. Make sure you lock this position. Make sure your back is straight. Then you start your azkar. Then you start your dhikr. Okay? What do we say in this position? Okay? So in the ruku position, we say, Subhana Rabbiyal Azim. Everybody repeat after me. Subhana
Rabbiyal
Azim.
Subhana
Rabbiyal
Azim.
Alright? We say this three times in the ruku position. In the ruku position, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, supplicate Allah to the best of your ability. So we supplicate Allah, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. But write this down. It is haram to recite Quran in the ruku position. It is haram to recite Quran. You can't recite the Fatiha in this position. You can't recite Qul Huwallahu Ahad. You can't recite Qul A'udhu Birabbi Falaq in the ruku position. It is haram to recite the Quran in the ruku position. I'm going to test you on that.
What?
It is haram to recite the Quran in the bowing position, in the ruku position. The only thing that you do in this position is supplicate Allah. And in this position, we say Subhana Rabbiyal Azim. We say this three times. It must be an odd number. Now we can say Subhana Rabbiyal Azim. It has to be an odd number. We can say at least three, or we can say 99. We can say however many times we want. Okay? But it must be an odd number. But the thing that we cannot do In the ruku position is recite the Quran. We cannot recite Quran in the ruku position. So everybody again, repeat after me. Subhana.
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 Rabbiyal.
Rabbiyal.
Adhim.
Subhana.
Rabbiyal.
Rabbiyal.
Adhim.
The women. Subhana. Rabbiyal.
Rabbiyal.
Adhim.
Subhana.
Rabbiyal.
Rabbiyal.
Adhim. This means glory to my Lord, the most great. Glory be to my Lord, the most great. So we say in the ruku position, make sure I lock my position. Make sure my eyes are facing the ground. Make sure my back is parallel to the ground. Okay, make sure my hands are on my knees. Make sure my fingers are spread out. Okay, once I lock this position, because if I do not lock this position, okay, Rasulullah said, the one who does not take his time in his salat, your prayer is not valid. So take your time. That's why the salat is important. You have to master your salat. You have to have discipline in your salat. You can't fake the salat. So now, the standing position is called what? The standing position is called what? The bowing position is called what? Okay, alhamdulillah. Okay, now. We went from Qiyam, Allahu Akbar, right? Opening supplication. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika wa tabarakatuka. Boom. Fadiya, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Boom. Little short story. Qul huwallahu ahad. Boom. Now I'm going into ruku. Right? When I go into ruku, I raise the hands. Allahu Akbar. Boom. Hands on the knees. Fingers spread. Back straight. Eyes down. Arms out. And I say, Subhana Rabbi Aladdin, Subhana Rabbi Aladdin, Subhana Rabbi Aladdin. I can ask Allah for love, whatever I want to ask Allah for love, right now. Okay? Now I'm going back to the next position. I'm going back to the standing position. Qiyam again. Okay? So I'm going from the Qiyam. I'm going from Ruku back to standing up. Okay? Now, there's two ways to do this.